G'day, wonderful human. My name's Dylan Dance. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Grab a coffee, grab a chair, grab a Vegemite sandwich, grab whatever you want to grab. Let's talk some natural philosophy. There's quite a few people who watch these now, so it's something of a community. And I don't know any of you personally, but I do care about you all, and I just want to make sure you're all doing okay. So please, if you're struggling, reach out to somebody, leave a comment down under, and you know the rest of the community will get around you. So I will put up some good places you can talk to people. There's always people you can talk to, so you just got to reach out. All right, back to my stupid video. Hopefully you can get a few minutes of enjoyment out of it. Let's watch some Full Metal Alchemist.
So, if you pray and polish the altar enough times, someone who's dead will be brought back to life?
Something like that.
An anime girl a day keeps the real ones away. That's creepy as hell.
この人はエドワード。エドワード。国家資格を失わずに済むよ。エド。
一つ質問いいかな。ニーナとアレキサンダー、どこ行った？
そういうことだ。いや。連戦しやがった。動物実験にも。進歩は無数の人体実験の賜物だろ。
Wow, that's extremely traumatic. That's the weirdest thing I've ever seen in my life. How about we just go back and talk about the alchemy now? Because that is too much. I could deal with the people getting eaten, but turning kids into dogs? I'm out. I'm gonna head out. So let's talk about this alchemy, because I skipped over that. So the goals of alchemy went far beyond just trying to create some golden nuggets. It was this whole complex spiritual worldview. So the whole thing as well in alchemy is that everything is transmutable. And that really is close to what we currently think in physics. If some of the popular models in theoretical physics are correct, well then this matter stuff, like anything in this room, can transmute into a quanta of pure force, like photons, like light, and back again. So that is very similar to what, you know, alchemy suggests, in that everything is transmutable. So, you know, they kind of got that one right. And currently in physics, our view of matter is more like light than, you know, solid, physical, you know, impenetrable, hard stuff. So that's kind of really interesting. And it can transmute between, you know, this pure force stuff and seemingly, you know, this matter stuff. So even though alchemy never reached its goals, it still kind of remains in society today because alchemists were really just early chemists. And chemistry is really just easy physics. But anyway, we'll leave it there. Let's watch some more.
It's an adventure in creative self-expression that is limited only by the boundaries of your own imagination.
Cooking is a science!
No, it isn't. It's an art!
Well, science is kind of an art. They're kind of the same thing, in my opinion. Science is like God's art. And when I say God here, I don't know what I'm talking about. I don't mean the personal God, but maybe, you know, some higher form of a God that is nature or something.
Alchemy, the science of understanding deep, is not an all-powerful art. It is impossible to create. This is the law of equivalent exchange, the basis of all alchemy. In accordance with this law, there is a taboo among...
Even though their whole Philosopher's Stone, the Harry Potter thing, you know, that never worked out either. They weren't too far off again, because we can do that today with particle accelerators and a lot of money. You can actually turn other metals into gold. Now, you're only going to get microscopic amounts of gold, the cost of making, you know, doing this procedure is going to cost you a lot more than the gold is worth. So, you know, there's really no point. But, you know, you can do it. All right. So it's very much possible to create a material from another material. The universe and everything in it would be very, very different if that weren't possible.
Carbon, 20 kilograms. Ammonia, 4 liters. Lime, 1.5 kilograms. Phosphorus, 800 grams. Salt, 250 grams. Saltpeter, 100 grams. Sulfur, 80 grams. Fluorine, 7.5. Iron, 5. Silicon, 3 grams. And trace amounts of 15 other elements.
What's that?
It's all the ingredients of the average adult human body, down to the last specks of protein in your eyelashes. And even though some... bringing a human to life, there's still something missing. Something scientists haven't been able to find in centuries of research. Wondering, all those ingredients can be bought on a child's... There's no magic to it. Time, Rose. Science will find a way. Science is the answer to everything.
All right, let's have a pause here. He said there's no magic to it. There's no magic to the human body or whatever we are. And I have to disagree with him. Like, clearly he's never studied any physics, because... there's some magical SHIT stuff in physics. Not sure I agree with what he said about science having the answer to everything. It might not. It takes it to a very philosophical place, right? And you ask yourself those big questions about, you know, where did this place come from? What's going on? And who knows if science will be able to answer those sorts of questions. And I'm just like everyone else. I don't have the answers to those big questions. I love to think about them and I have lots of fun ideas, but nobody knows, or nobody has even the slightest clue. You know, I can see a pattern, but I can't imagine who made the pattern. I can see a clock, but I can't envision the clockmaker. And as Einstein said, the human mind can't even perceive the four dimensions it is within. So how is it meant to perceive of a god, whom before 1,000 years and 1,000 dimensions are as one?
Yoshi, kouchukushiki o kakuzo. Ato wa tamashii no jōhō da.
So brutal, but so interesting. I'm loving it. I want to watch this show. But I was really enjoying that whole philosophical view of God. I like it. All right, I think that'll do it for this video. That was just a whole bunch of traumatic and sad scenes, but it does look like a really interesting show and very philosophical. So let me know down under what you want me to watch next, guys, and I'll catch you next time.